Let's go. It's your man, Mike Bowens, coming to you once again, live and direct. Listen, I got another powerful message for you. This message is entitled, Pray for peace when you don't have any. Pray for peace when you don't have any. I don't know about you, but sometimes in life, there's so many obstacles that stacked up against you, right? And it can feel overwhelming, whether it's something to do with your kids, something to do in your marriage, something to do with just you, something to do with work, right? Something to do with some type of bills, whatever. And sometimes you can just feel overwhelmed and you don't have any peace, right? But I'm reminded of in Philippians chapter 4, and I believe it's verse, Philippians chapter 4, verse 6 through 7, it says, be anxious for nothing, but in everything by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known to God. And the peace of God, which passeth all understanding, shall keep your hearts and minds through Christ Jesus. Listen, the first step was be anxious for nothing. That means you gotta train yourself not to worry about what you can't control. You gotta train yourself not to worry about what you can't control and how it's gonna work out and how things are gonna change and how the bill's gonna get paid and how your kid's gonna make it through life or whatever. You see, training your mind to think on the goodness of God takes skill, takes work, takes deliberate effort, day in and day out. And so the first thing it says, be anxious for nothing, but in everything, in how many things? In everything, by prayer and supplication. That means going to God for your needs. I remember when I was a little kid, my mom used to say to me, you know, I was expressing to her, I want this and I want that for the future and I want to be able to do that for the future. She said, you just got to pray. You got to talk to God about everything. And I'm like, what are you talking about? Like, I'm trying to tell you my problems and you tell me to pray to God and about everything. Obviously, I was a child. So when I was a child, I thought I was a child. But now I'm a grown man. I put childish things away. And as I begin to develop and mature and learn, everything that you need and desire starts with prayer. You want a better job? It starts with prayer. You want to have your own business? God will give you the ideas and the concepts and how to through prayer. You want your relationship to get better with your children? It starts with prayer. You want your children off of drugs? It starts with prayer. You want to have a better relationship with your spouse? It starts with prayer. You want to lose weight, want to get in shape, it starts with prayer. Need for your church to be a more loving, more better church, whatever, it starts with prayer. Anything that you want to see happen starts with prayer. And see, what happens is the enemy tries to keep us so busy, or he tries to bog us down with so much pressure and so much weight that you don't feel no peace, that prayer is the last thing on your mind. But I want to encourage somebody out there today that prayer should be the first thing on your mind. Because when you pray, that's when things can change. When you pray, that's when God can give you the peace that you so need, that you desire. I don't know about you, but sometimes I'm going through so many battles and so many spiritual attacks that the physical eye cannot see, but I know exactly that's what's happening. And so sometimes I just will put my head down and I'll just say a prayer. And I just pray, I say, God, I need your peace right now. I need your joy right now. I need your love right now. I cast all my cares upon you right now in Jesus' name. And I put my praise music on. And if I got a bill that I need to pay, I put it on the floor and I start dancing on it. And I start praising God on it. Because guess what? I'm not going to allow the circumstances of this life to take away my peace. I'm not going to allow the circumstances of this life to take away my joy. I'm not going to allow the circumstances of this life to drive me insane. Right? So some things that's happening to you is not natural. It's supernatural. But sometimes you can't even explain that to people because they won't understand. Right? And so the best thing to do is to pray about it. Pray for peace when you don't have any. Pray for peace when you're at your jobs, even if you and people's like talking about you or saying things to get you written up and saying things to get you fired. Listen, sometimes you just gotta pray within yourself. I know a person who's a nurse, and at the job that they're at, they're constantly under surveillance and people are constantly doing things to try to get them in a position to get fired. And I told him, I said, listen, you got to put some anointed oil on your hands. Every time you go to a room, you touch a doorknob, you're praying for that room, right? And when you sit down, you anoint in that place and you pray within your heart. Not all the time do you have a chance to kneel down and pray. Sometimes you just got to pray silently, but you're praying on the inside. What, you think God can't read your mind? You think God can't read your thoughts? Oh, it's probably staying for the truth. He can read every thought that you have. And so the thing is, you got to pray for peace, because that's what the devil wants to rob from you, is your peace. Because if he can get your peace, he can get you to act in frustration. He can get you to act out of anger. And I don't know about you, but have you ever been to the point where you got so mad that you blacked out and you didn't even know what was happening? You didn't know what was going on, right? Relationships can be solved. I mean, relationships could have been still together today if they would have stopped arguing and said, you know what? You're not my enemy. I'm not your enemy. Let's pray. Lock hands and pray. And then the peace of God is going to fill them. Oh, there's a bomb going on. Boom! The peace of God is going to fill you when you begin to pray, right? And then the issue that you're facing no longer seems like an issue anymore. And God gives you an escape. He begins to give you a way out of the situation that you're facing. But if the enemy can keep you blinded to prayer, if he can keep you blinded to you having peace, if he can keep you from giving thanksgiving. See, here's another facet of what I want to talk about. What the scripture said. You pray about everything that you need from God and that you're facing, that you hope to receive, that you hope to accomplish in the future, right? The next thing is you make your request made known. And then the other thing that it said was thanksgiving. How many times have people prayed, but because they have not seen it with their eyes yet, they're still not sure if they got it? The Bible says, when you pray, believe that you receive those things that you pray for and you shall have them. So that means soon as I pray for it, I got it already. And then you got to give thanksgiving to God. You got to give praise. You got to put your worship music on if you have to. And thank God. God, I thank you that my body's healed. God, I thank you that my children are getting off drugs. God, I thank you that my business is exploding. God, I thank you that I no longer am addicted to this issue anymore, addicted to this drug anymore. Lord, I thank you that my marriage is coming together after you already prayed about it. You see what I'm saying? You give God thanks, you give God praise about what it is that you already have prayed for. And then the peace of God is going to fill you, right? So you're never going by what you see, you're going by what you believe. So everything around you can be falling to pieces. You continue to pray. You continue to make your request made known to God. His peace is going to fill you over and above anything you can ask or think. And then after that, you give God praise. You give God thanks for what you already prayed for, because you know it's only a matter of time for it manifests in the physical realm, right? Of that of what you pray for. This is your man, Mike Bowens. I hope this message encouraged, inspired somebody out there to pray for peace when you don't have any. Until next time, I'm saying, be blessed.